Yeah, that's working much better.
Is this even gonna work? Trying to mount this trolling motor up to the Beavertail. They don't sell a motor bracket for this particular Beavertail model. So what I've got is a leaf spring shackle. And what I'm trying to do is bolt this leaf spring shackle into the gunnel of this Beavertail and then mount this trolling motor. I don't know if this is gonna work, but let's see if we can get this shackle mounted up to this boat without making too much of a mess. All right, got to tighten that down. Got the leaf spring shackled up. We got some 2-inch bolts. Got a washer and a lock nut on the top, and we got a lock nut on the bottom. We got the motor mounted up here. Actually added a lag screw to help secure the wooden block to the leaf spring shackle. That way now the motor has 2 points of contact that are secure, and the wooden block is married to that shackle right there. So we are mounted up. I think we are ready to go. Out here at the pond, I'm gonna throw the boat on, take it for a test ride and see how it does. While Hudson puts his life jacket on here, let's take a look at it real quick. So we've got the trolling motor mounted up. It's nice and secure. We've got it bolted through the gunnel and sitting off to the side here. And I'm gonna put him in a little deeper water. We'll drop that motor down. We'll see how it works. Try going straight, buddy. You got weeds in it? I think he's getting on plane. Side mount was a great idea in concept, but I think I mounted it too far forward. The boat would not go straight, as you saw last night. Back to the drawing board. Here's what we came up with. I had some miscellaneous brackets and pieces of spare metal, and I think that's actually a spare tire mount bracket. So I've got it temped up here. I'm gonna get some heavier duty L brackets, but I think we're in business. We'll have this baby mounted right off the bat. Should go straight and square. Works like a charm. This bracket, got the trolling motor mounted. We are ready for round two. You're going fast. Yeah, that's working much better. All right, stop it. There you go. Oh no. Nice. Round three, I think we may finally have it. We got a nice secure bracket on here, just some miscellaneous parts from the garage. This base bracket actually came off a spare tire holder, and then I married up with some L brackets to a vertical 2x4, gave it an extra little bit of lift just so these wings would clear. But it is really strong, really secure, and I think we are in business. Try not to laugh too hard, but the problem now was where I'm gonna be sitting way far forward, towards the middle of this boat, couldn't reach my handle here. So I actually heated up a piece of conduit, flattened it out, and then just electrical taped it to this handle. It is very easily turned up here from the front. So we will see if that works. If it does, I'll come up with something a little bit more permanent and paint it up, of course, to match everything else. I'd like to make this removable. That way it's not such a long apparatus here. Went ahead and added some clips here. That way I can easily pop it off. I want to take this whole assembly out really quickly and I don't have to untie this knot. Little changes when you get on the water can make a big difference. And for the final touch, putting the skirt that goes on this layout line back on here. This is a waterproof skirt that just pulls up and over you. and your feet actually hold it in place down there where I cut off the bottom flap. So your feet hold the skirt in place, you pull it up and over you, you get a layout blind. We're gonna take it to the lake, see if she floats, and see how that trolling motor works. Back down here at the lake for round three. Got the bracket on here, the trolling motor put on, and we got a little bit of a chop on the water, so it should be a good test for this thing. Get the motor on, give it a go. Got the battery all the way up at the front to help with weight distribution. Trolling motor's on, battery's in, let's go for a ride. Think it's gonna work. The boat itself only drafts about 3 to 4 inches of water, so my limiting factor, of course, will be the trolling motor set up, but I can actually raise him even higher to get him even shallower. But I think we finally have found success. Third time's a charm. Actually ended up taking an inch and a half pipe, and I did not have a reducer, but I did have some screws, and I've reduced it down to a 1-inch pipe, and I heated this guy up to where he would perfectly slide over this handle, and it was a little bit loose to start with, so I did a double wrap of electrical tape to tighten it up a little bit. Now this sleeve slides over this handle just perfectly. It's a little bit snug. That's exactly what we want. That way when we twist it, it doesn't spin. So it's a little snug going on. We can still twist the motor, and then if we want to take it off for transport, no problem. So here it is, the final product. Got the trolling motor bracket mounted up. We've got a removable, sturdy handle added so I can reach it from the front. We added some clips here, went ahead and painted those up. Back support in place. We're officially ready. If you like this project, please let me know in the comments. Something a little bit different for me, working on gear and boats, but I could do a few more of these videos. I got a couple other projects to work on, so let me know in the comments. But as always, thanks for following along. We'll catch you on the next one.